Hello, my name is Raphaël Poumarède, and the purpose of this presentation is to explain you how to obtain the deployment files that are needed to deploy SAS Viya 4. First, we will look at how to do it manually, but there will also be another video to explain you how to do it in an automated way. So when a customer purchases a SAS offering, he will get two things. First, an email summarizing the order contents, like the products that are included in the order, the site number, which identifies the company of the customer. And the second thing that the customer will have is an access to the mysas.com portal. It is a public portal from where the customer will be able to download the deployment assets. The goal of this presentation is to detail this process. So you can see a screenshot of the software order email, and there is this button, Get Started. And if you click on it, it should open the mysas.com portal on the page corresponding to the order. To log in into the portal, it is necessary to have a sas.com account or a SAS profile. And the customer representative who has received the email might already have such account. Otherwise, he has to create a new SAS profile. Customers can also use the SAS profiles to access resources from communities.sas.com or to download tools and utilities, for example, from support.sas.com. Once you are logged in, you will see all the orders associated to your SAS profile. If you click on the order, you can see the details of it, products, expiration date, and you also have the links to the documentation and a drop-down menu to select the version. So, before you click on the download deployment asset button, you need to select a cadence and a version in this drop-down menu. So you basically have two cadences that you need to choose between them. So you have the stable cadence, which is basically a monthly update cycle, okay? Or you have the LTS cadence, where you will get a new version of the software every 6 months. One of the main differences I would say is that, of course, with the monthly release, you will get the new features as soon as they are available. However, the duration of the support will be shorter, and you will be expected to update very regularly. Whereas with the LTS cadence, you will be on a longer term support, because you will be supported for about 2 years, okay, from when you install the latest version. But of course, you will not get the new features as quickly as if you were choosing the monthly cadence. In the portal, you also have the links to download the certificate and the license. Okay, so deployment assets, certificates, and license. So if we look at the kind of files that corresponds to what we can download, you can see that the deployment assets comes as a tar.gzip file, which is an archive file. The certificates come as a zip file, which is also an archive file. For both of those files, you will have to extract their content. And the last one is a license file, which comes as a text file, but using the JSON web token format. Okay, so it's not a human readable format, but it can be applied to an environment, for example, to renew the license. Now, if we look at the detail of the deployment assets file name, you can see that it already provides a lot of good information. So the order number is in the file name, the cadence, stable or LTS, the version, the exact release level, which is the patch level if you want. And also at the end of the file name, you have a timestamp of the download, okay? So you know exactly when you have downloaded this file. Also, set units and certificates don't have to be downloaded individually for a deployment. You don't need them for a fresh deployment. You might need the license to renew your license. Okay, you might need the license file to renew the license, and the certificates can be used to create the mirror. Okay, finally, when you unzip the deployment asset, it will create the SAS-based directory with a lot of content. The other files in this folder, like customization.yaml, site config, site.yaml, will be customer specific, and please refer to the official deployment documentation to understand what they are used for. And this is the end of the presentation. If you want to automate this process, please watch the second part of the video, which explains how to use the SAS API and something called the Order CLI to download your deployment assets from the command line. Thank you.